In this video, I'll show you how to configure your Nvidia GPU to work with Kasm Workspaces so that you can unlock GPU accelerated sessions on your Kasm deployment. I'll also showcase our new AI Workspace registry packed with ready-to-use GPU-enabled environments for your AI and ML workflows. In this video, I'll be using Harvester as my hypervisor, but you can follow along with any platform of your choice, whether it's Proxmox, vSphere, a cloud provider, or even just a bare metal Linux machine. First things first, let me show you how to set up GPU PCI passthrough from your host to Harvester so that your Harvester VMs can have direct access to your GPU. For more detailed instructions, you can also refer to the Harvester documentation on PCI passthrough. It will be linked in the description below. If you have already configured GPU passthrough to your hypervisor, or if you're doing this on a bare metal Linux machine, feel free to skip this step. It is also important to note that when you pass through a GPU to your hypervisor, that GPU becomes unavailable to your host. In my setup, I'm using two GPUs, one for the host system and the other dedicated to Harvester for use with Kasm Workspaces. Alternatively, you can also use virtual GPUs or vGPUs instead of PCI passthrough, but this approach requires enterprise-grade Nvidia GPUs and licensed drivers. This setup is out of scope for this video and will not be covered here. To do a PCI passthrough in Harvester, go to Advanced and then PCI Devices. If you haven't yet, you need to first enable the PCI controller. Once the PCI controller is enabled, go to Images and then click Create to create an image. In this video, I'll use the Ubuntu Noble Server cloud image. We recommend that you also use Ubuntu Noble Server. Next, I'll create a virtual machine network. Go to Networks, Virtual Machine Networks, and then click Create. Name your network, choose the type as Untagged Network, and choose the MGMT cluster network. Remember that this is being done on a fresh install of Harvester. Before I provision a VM, I'll also create an SSH key to access my VM. To do this, go to Advanced, SSH Keys, and then click Create. Give it a name and paste in your SSH public key and click Create. Now let me go ahead and create a virtual machine for hosting Kasm. Go to Virtual Machines and click Create. Give your VM a name, define the number of cores and memory you want to allocate, and also select the SSH key. Now go to the Volumes tab, select the Ubuntu Noble image you just uploaded, and set a disk size. For this demo, I'll set the disk size to 100 gigs. Next, go to the Networks tab and choose the VM network that you just created. Finally, go to PCI Devices and search for your Nvidia card. As you can see, I have two GPUs here, the Quadro K420 that I use for my host and the RTX A2000 that I will use for the PCI passthrough. Simply select your GPU and the associated audio device and click Enable Passthrough. Now that the passthrough for the devices are enabled, simply attach them to your VM. Finally, click Create to create your virtual machine. Once the VM is in the running state, you can verify if your GPU is properly allocated to your VM by going to your VM annotations. As you can see, my PCI devices are properly allocated to this VM as shown here. Now, let me go ahead and SSH into my VM. To enable GPU passthrough to container-based Kasm sessions, you can refer to our documentation and follow the steps covered there. The first step is to obviously install Kasm. So I'll just go to the installation guide and copy-paste these four commands to install Kasm single server setup. Once the installation is complete, the randomly generated default credentials for your Kasm deployment will be printed on the terminal. You can now simply log into your Kasm deployment with these default credentials. Let me now verify if my Nvidia card is visible from inside the VM by running this command. As you can see, my GPU is indeed listed here, but I still want to install the drivers and the Nvidia Container Toolkit. If you're using Ubuntu Noble, you can simply execute this bash script that's mentioned in our docs. It first checks if your Nvidia card is available, and then adds the official PPA for the graphic drivers on Ubuntu and installs the package. Next, it installs the latest available version of the Nvidia drivers that are compatible with your GPU. Finally, it also installs the Nvidia Container Toolkit and configures the Nvidia Docker runtime. You can save this script into a file and then run it with sudo privileges. It will then install the appropriate drivers and the Nvidia Container Toolkit and also configure the Nvidia Docker runtime. Once the script finishes executing, reboot the machine. After the reboot, you can verify if the Nvidia drivers are properly installed. As you can see on my setup, Nvidia driver version 570.133.20 is installed along with CUDA version 12.8. To verify if Nvidia Docker runtime is configured properly, you can execute this command which lists all the configured runtimes that Docker can use. And as you can see, Nvidia is one of them. Let me now go ahead and download some workspaces on my Kasm deployment. I also want to install the Kasm AI registry so I can use some of the AI workspaces. To do that, simply go to the Registries tab, and if you're on the latest version 1.17, you will find the Kasm AI registry in the registry spotlight. Simply click Install. Now go back to the Available Workspaces tab and filter by Kasm AI Images registry. You can now see all the available AI workspaces. I will install the Easy Diffusion image and also the CUDA-enabled PyTorch image. By default, all the images from the AI registry have GPU enabled. But if you want to enable GPU Passthrough for other images, you can simply go to your workspace settings and set the GPU count to 1. You can also increase the count to more than 1 if you want to pass through multiple GPUs to the session. You can also override the number of GPUs on your agent so that multiple containers can access the same GPU. For example, if you set the GPU override setting on your agent to 4, it means 4 container sessions can use the same GPU. However, it is not possible to evenly distribute the GPU across these containers. To achieve that, you need to use vGPU instead. While we are on the Kasm admin page, it is also advised to verify if Kasm is properly able to detect your GPU. Simply go to Infrastructure, Docker Agents, edit the agent, and then go to the Details tab. Scroll down until you find GPU info and extend the field. As you can see, my GPU is indeed listed here, so that means Kasm can see my GPU. Similarly, you can scroll furthermore until you see Docker info and extend the field to verify if the Nvidia Docker runtime is properly recognized by Kasm. Now that I have some workspaces installed, let me launch the Ubuntu Noble workspace to demonstrate that GPU pass-through is working correctly. As you can see, I am able to see my GPU from within the container. I will also launch the Firefox app inside the workspace and run some WebGL tests to confirm that Firefox is utilizing the GPU for rendering. Please note that Chrome doesn't support GPU acceleration at the moment, and we are working on fixing it. Next up, let me open the Easy Diffusion workspace that already comes with the GPU enabled. As you can see, the workspace comes preloaded with all the necessary tools required to run Easy Diffusion locally in the container. When the environment is done setting up, it automatically launches the browser and opens the Easy Diffusion interface where you can generate images from a text prompt. Similarly, let me also showcase the CUDA-enabled PyTorch workspace, which also comes with the GPU enabled, since it's part of our AI workspaces registry. This workspace includes PyTorch pre-installed, and as you can see, PyTorch is successfully detecting the GPU, confirming that the GPU pass-through is working as expected. Another very cool workspace we have that benefits from GPU pass-through is Blender. By default, it doesn't have GPU enabled, so you can simply edit the workspace settings and set the GPU count to 1. And now, you can use Blender workspace for your VFX workflows with GPU support. All the links to our GPU documentation can be found in the description below. That'll be all for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.